Hello, Malty. Miraculously, meticulously, memorably, multi-moody mercurial memes. Thank you, Isaac Wilson, for that rather long-winded malt mention, which is fine. A malt mention's a malt mention. Some of them I have to kind of edit down and compress a wee bit. But that's fine, Isaac. Thank you. This is Ralfy Review 855 from the Bothy, in the Bothy. It's winter time. I'm heating the place for a bit, but it's never quite warm enough. I need a wee drop of a bottled sunshine to bring some summer sunshine and tropical heat into the cold grey Bothy. This'll do. Worthy Park. Single Estate Reserve. Bottled at 45%. And it does have an age statement on it, although the age statement is not in the front label. The age statement is part of the description in the back. And it says, barrels between 6 to 10 years old. I paid £50 for this bottle of rum. I bought it a few months ago. I'm not sure whether I bought it before or after this rum was named the world's best rum 2020 by some big spirits award people. There's a few options out there. But I'm happy to recommend it. It's proper rum. Sipping rum. It's well made. It comes from the Worthy Park Distillery from Jamaica. It's kind of towards the centre of the island and the southern part of the island. And it goes back to the 17th century, was when they first planted sugarcane fields and harvested them for whatever they could make profit out of. And of course, one of the profitable items was making rum. But Worthy Park don't just make rum now, they also make vodka. So if you're looking for a bottle of Jamaican vodka, somebody is somewhere. Just look out for the Worthy Park bottling. They do two styles. They also do, and I'll bring it out now to show you, just while the rum's settling down, you understand. They do part of their range, rum bar. Now, this is often overlooked and underrated by whiskey drinkers who are trying rums. There are quite a growing number of rum options out there globally, but I find myself going back to the Caribbean time and time again, whether it be to Cuba, Grenada, whether it be to St. Vincent, or to Jamaica, because the variety within the geographical area of the Caribbean is quite remarkable. The diversity of flavours, and importantly, it's the maturity of the rum industry on these locations who have survived through self-sufficiency and developing a singular identity because they've got a lot of competition between each other. So that's the place to start. If you're a whiskey drinker looking for that alternative moment, the alternative to malts, which I recommend everybody who has a whiskey collection has some spirits from another style of production, whether it be bourbon, rye, rum, mezcal, because it's good just to kind of challenge your palate. Not just with the flavour, but with the form and the character that you get from the diversity of spirits out there. Every spirit has a story to tell. Some are pretty rough stories, and they're only worth experiencing once. There are some rough rums out there, and they've been produced as mixers for blending. And it's only in recent years, particularly to a certain extent at rum festivals, but importantly, it's rum tables at whisky festivals. This is where we're seeing the likes of a new generation coming through, for example, from Foursquare, from Barbados, from Mount Gay in Barbados, from Havana Club in Cuba. You're seeing these rums which have been overlooked and underrated. Now, a word of caution. There has been that bliss point for the drinker where you could buy a really good rum for less than a bottle of whiskey, but that is changing. That is changing. It's worth bearing in mind that spirit matures more quickly in tropical climates, in hotter ambient climates. Therefore, the age statement is worth roughly 2 and 2.5 times what an age statement is on a whiskey, particularly one from Scotland. Well, in the freezy north. So let's start with the nose here. Warm, ripe, rich, luscious sugarcane, absolutely. It's what I'm looking for. And very important, I don't want my rum to be over distilled. It's cola, mango, banana. There's something creamy in there, like a butterscotch. Taste. Very, very good. Wonderfully well made. You get the alcoholic nip, but it doesn't burn. 45%, not quite cask strength. But it's a busy rum. There's a lot of flavours there. And importantly, they're not flavours that you come across in your average Scotch whisky. Occasionally, you'll get indicators if a whisky's been rum cask matured. But there's no doubting from the very first sip, this is an excellent quality rum. It has those tropical flavours. But more than that, there's something about Caribbean sourced rums. They have an energy about them. They have that sensation of hot climate production. Now, recently, I was asked to sample a number of British-made rums. And I have to say, they were very poor quality. And even by the taste alone, I could tell that they had been produced in a stainless steel convenience still, something like an ice still or a Holstein or something like that. Probably an ice still. One of these little compact press the button stills. And they're just a disaster. So just to remind you Caribbean rum producers, there's a big surge in rum production in Britain, but don't you worry about too much about the competition, because I doubt there are any British rum makers that can produce this sort of quality. They're interesting. Some of them are cleanly made. But at the moment, too many of them are simply lacking character and definition of any kind. I'm going to add a wee drop of water to this. Not a lot, just a drop. 2 millilitres. Doesn't need much. The price of rum is going up fast. Just to forewarn you, if you're looking at a bottle of rum as an alternative and you say, hang about, I can get a decent bottle of Scotch whisky or bourbon or whatever for less than that, well, go with your wallet. Never ever feel the need because you want to try something new or something exotic or because people are recommending, like me, that you should be forking out extra money over and above your budget. Just don't do it. Because the more you're prepared to pay, the more these businesses are prepared to charge. Having said that, I think that the price you're paying for Worthy Park at the moment is relatively worth it for the quality of what you're getting. This distillery relaunched itself in 2005 after being closed for several decades due to overproduction of rum in Jamaica. So it was really left to Appleton Estate and Hampden Distillery and other, you know, established Jamaican distilleries producing a certain style. But recently, when Worthy Park reopened, they made a big commitment to spend a large sum of money, because these cost a fortune, and they sourced their pot stills, 100% copper pot still, from Scotland. Now, they bought them from Forsyth, the still makers, and that's an expensive company to buy anything from. It's just the way it is. But they have a still there now, which would never be used for producing Scotch whiskey. It just wouldn't. It's got two dunder pots. Now, these basically, the spirit comes over the still, and before it's cooled, it's refluxing into miniature pot stills at a lower temperature. And it creates a little bit of refinement, but not too much refinement. It's a traditional way of producing. It works a treat. And when you look at the stills, by the way, the still itself, the big pot still, the one that it reminds you of in Scotland is Lagavulin. Big fat pot, big short fat neck, and big fat line arm, going descending line arm. So these folk, and goodness knows where they got the design, but it was probably lying around from historical designs. But the results speak for themselves. It's more or less pitch perfect for a reputable, global quality, accessible rum. So there we have it. Now I've added some water now. Let's nose it, sniff it, and give a malt mark. Give a rum mark. I do this, another blooper. Bloopers happen. Once you've added water, the nose becomes more buttery. It is seemingly sweet, but the sensation range is actually really good. There's a touch of savoury in here as well. So particularly if you like your beefier Speyside whiskies, like Glenfarclas, for example, you're going to enjoy this. This is a great alternative. And I'm glad I bought it. A little bit of lime oil, honeysuckle, there's floral notes in the background, some mild spice including powdered ginger, and a little bit of cardamom. Nice sweet arrival. Turns dry, the cask notes hit, tannins, lovely tannins in the development, the cola, mango, banana, triptych thing going on, quite sultana as well in the development, little bit of menthol and camphor towards the finish, and the finish is clean and crisp. So it's interesting, you get a sweet arrival, a sour bitter development, and a slight savoury salty finish. So a fascinating array of sensations in with the flavours, which really carry this wonderfully, wonderfully well. And if it won Best Rum in the World award, well, my opinion is they deserve it. This is a world-class rum. It is very, very good. And if I'm going to buy another bottle of this, I better be quick. Wonderful texture. There's no Caribbean mist forming in here because of the refluxing. And there's no doubt about it. This is filtered. You can taste it. But it's not excessively so. It's not starting to diminish the presence and the palate. It's a lovely, lovely array and combination. Very, very good. What will I give this? It's a rum mark. I found my cards, by the way, that I couldn't find last review. So, or let me see. It's an easy one, actually. 90. 90 out of 100 is a rum mark. From the Bothy, for a wonderful alternative. particularly in winter time in the cold, because it's bottled sunshine, and with a wee bit of reggae music in the background, and a one of these red infrared lamps in your cosy safe space, it's a wonderful combination. I'm Ralphie, I'm done and dusted here. If you want to pop back again, I'll be talking a bit more about rums and the extras. I'll be talking about how I got into rums, where I found rums, and I'm just going to waffle. Yeah, I'll be honest with you. I'm just going to waffle about rums for about 15 minutes. So if you want to join me, you're very welcome to do so, because I will be sharing a few little pointers, suggestions and helpful hints with you to help you on your way. I'm Ralphie. See you soon. Bye-bye.